A whirlwind wardrobe change. Meghan Markle transforms her look in minutes after ditching her Bondi beach maxi for a $2,300 designer dress and $528 heels for school visit. Day 4 of the royal tour kicked off bright and early at Sydney's iconic Bondi beach, before the Duchess of Sussex managed a quick outfit change at Admiralty House before traveling to MacArthur Girls' School. First donning a maxi dress from Melbourne-born designer Martin Grant's 2019 resort collection, Meghan later switched up her outfit for a Roxendale and Sick two-tone crepe midi dress. She also changed her hairstyle, from a relaxed ponytail on the beach to a half-up half-down style while at the school. The Roxendale design, which retails for $2,376, GBP £1,295, is Meghan's first nod to the British fashion industry while on tour. While Roxendale is originally Serbian, she has been based in London for many years and shows at London Fashion Week each year. The Athena style taps into 1950s fashions, and features an A-line shape and gently pleated skirt. The dress is described online as the perfect choice for cocktail parties or weddings, and coincidentally perfectly matched the MacArthur Girls' School uniform. Meghan paired this outfit with Stuart Weitzman's Legend pumps, which retail for $528, GBP £287, and what is believed to be Burke's Bees chic earrings and blue topaz. Earlier on in the day, Meghan wore a floor-length gown by Martin Grant to Sydney's Bondi Beach. The $1,615, GBP £880, style featured a straight, sleeveless neckline and full pleated skirt, with contrasting caramel and white stripes. The pregnant Duchess, 37, paired the contemporary design with $147, GBP £80, Costanier canvas wedges pedres, but she swiftly broke with royal protocol when she ditched them to step onto the sand. This was in stark contrast to her sister-in-law, the Duchess of Cambridge, who kept her high heels on when she visited Sydney's Manly in 2014. The pleated stripe-long dress is currently unavailable with online sale starting from December 15. It's not the first time the Duchess has worn Martin Grant, after she plumped for the French-based Australian on Tuesday and Thursday with her stylish trench coat. The Australian brand boasts a laundry list of celebrity clients including Cate Blanchett, and Blake Lively and Cameron Diaz, as well as international royals like Queen Rania of Jordan, who is a longtime fan of the brand. Prince Harry also opted for an Aussie label, opting for a blue shirt by Jack plus Jack. Meghan kept accessories to a minimum, wearing a simple $418 teardrop pendant from Los Angeles jewelry designer Adine Yaretter. The delicate, yellow gold necklace is made with 14 carats and paved diamonds, and will be available online from October 22. Since the start of their official engagements earlier this week, the Duchess' wardrobe choices have caused sartorial stock to sell out around the world. Dubbed the Meghan Effect, her outfit selections have crashed the sites of fashion labels including Karen G, Club Monaco, and Dion Lee, despite the Dion Lee dress only being available for pre-order at present. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex met with a local surfing community group One Wave early on Friday morning. This is an initiative dedicated to raising awareness for mental health and well-being in a fun and engaging way. Despite the early call time, Meghan was up at 4:30 a.m. to practice yoga before the busy day. This comes after reports that the Duchess shipped in yoga mats to Admiralty House, where she and Prince Harry are staying for the week. Their Royal Highnesses took part in the Fleur Friday session, where people of all ages share their experiences of mental health issues, before meeting with members of the public gathered alongside the beach. Within 20 minutes of the royal visit, One Wave's official website had crashed due to the volume of traffic. Later on Friday, the Sussexes will participate in a youth advocacy program which aims to unite and inspire young people to be inclusive. The newlyweds will also engage with students to discuss topical issues such as social justice and youth empowerment. In the afternoon, the Duke will scale the Sydney Harbour Bridge accompanied by Prime Minister Scott Morrison and athletes to raise the official flag of the Invictus Games. Friday's engagements will wrap up with calls on the Leader of the Opposition at Admiralty House, and the Prime Minister at Kirribee House.